Hi, my name is Don Dent, and I am the director of the Kim School of Global Missions at Gateway Seminary in Ontario, California. I'm also a 30-year emeritus missionary with the International Mission Board, serving in Southeast Asia, South Asia, and the Pacific Rim during that time. And I've been back now in the States for almost 8 years, training up the next generation of missionaries, because God continues to call out young adults and older adults to go to the nations and take the gospel of Jesus Christ and to transform lives and to start churches and to see those churches continuing ministry among their own people groups and their own languages. And in fact, right now in the world, God is working in so many amazing ways. I've had the chance to be in a part of Asia the last couple of years where there are, we believe, probably over 25,000 new churches that have grown up from the ministry of local believers partnering along with these IMB missionaries. And just an explosion where tens and hundreds, perhaps millions, but hundreds of thousands of mostly Hindus are coming to Christ. And in spite of the fact that it's against the law and they get into trouble, they ask to be baptized and they begin to share with the gospel with their friends and neighbors. And more people are coming to faith in that way. And I mean, it's just amazing to see what God is doing across every continent of the world and in multiple people groups. Right now, in this time of the coronavirus and this, it's a mess out there. There are places where missionaries can't even leave the house ever. Maybe they can go outside for 1 hour a week, or in some places, not even that. So ministry is challenging, but because so many places in the world, you know, people in the average home don't have extra food. There's no refrigerator. So when they can't leave home, or they're very limited, maybe the buses have quit moving or whatever it is, it's a crisis more than my house. My house, we've got lots of food. My wife has packed it in and we're fine. But no, that's not true of so much of the world today. And these Southern Baptist missionaries are leading 400 feeding projects in their communities all across the world, where people are having great difficulty earning a living to buy meals that day, or simply can't go to the market to get what they need. So a variety, but that's the typical kind of response, because as we partner together as Southern Baptist churches all across America, we're supporting 3,600 missionaries serving in every kind of a place imaginable. And whenever you hear something happening out there in the world, it doesn't matter where, just take a globe and spin it and put your finger on a spot, it is most likely that there are Southern Baptist missionaries not far from that place, who've learned language, lived there, have relationships, and have an ongoing ministry to share the good news, raise up disciples, and plant churches that reproduce and continue reaching their own people. This is one of the greatest opportunities that we have ever of being connected to God's concern for all the nations, for all the peoples of the world, and He's accomplishing it now through this partnership in so many exciting ways. Let me just mention a couple of ways that we do partner and can partner more effectively with the International Mission Board of the Southern Baptist Convention. Certainly, those missionaries really want you to pray for them. And there are multiple guides published by the International Mission Board, little booklets. You can get a one-month guide for praying for certain types of areas of the world or certain kinds of needs. There are regular updates on prayer lists. So in fact, it's often good if there's one or two people in a church who get some of that material and then maybe email all of their friends, or even print it out to those who don't have email, so that churches can be praying. There are also videos of missionaries and short stories or even connecting by Zoom or Skype to missionaries all over the world that you can talk to even during a worship service. And many would be very interested in that. So praying is so critical. And I just encourage you to look for opportunities to pray for missionaries. Also giving, as the Southern Baptist and then their church gives to and through the cooperative program. You might not even be aware of where all that's going, but a good portion of that is going to provide support for those missionaries all over the world. And so keep giving to your church and encourage your church to give to the cooperative program. Another way of giving very directly is through the Lottie Moon Christmas offering, which is taken every year. It's the largest mission offering in the world. And it's the reason why Southern Baptists have the largest mission agency in the Western world. And so you can give directly to that, you know, around Christmas time. And that money goes directly to doing work around the world. Such a great direct way to do that. And then you can actually connect with and partner with missionaries. They're missionaries who come to California, and they might be here 6 months or a year. And there are many Sundays they're probably not speaking somewhere. So if you wanted to invite them to come. And then you can also choose a missionary or two that you want to have a special ongoing relationship with, and you partner with them. You pray for them on a regular basis. They send you reports. Maybe you send small teams to go work alongside of them. These are all wonderful things. And then there's no better opportunity of getting from where we are here in America to out there around the world than by having people within our own church called to missions. And it can be young adults, it can be middle-aged adults, it can also be people who are just retiring. And maybe God bless them, they're able to retire, but they still want to contribute and do something really unusual and different. And so those people may have an opportunity to go somewhere around the world and use a skill that they have, or maybe like me, you know, just use a little bit of their gray hair, go to, you know, there are actually parts of the world where they like older people and they respect them. And people will be drawn to them just because they're a little bit older. So there's so many ways that we can partner with the International Mission Board, which is doing what God asks us to do, the commission that Jesus gave us all, to take the gospel to the whole world. And so every local Southern Baptist church has this opportunity of ministering in their own environment, in their own neighborhoods, while at the same time touching the whole world.